The time is nigh. Welcome to the entertainment on all fellows' lips, the arena where you, the mighty populace, become judge and jury, the world where the citizenry decide who will live and who will die. Welcome, fellow inhabitants of this blue-green globe, to the little sleep. Contestants on The Little Sleep.
See before me, the handle toward my hand. Come, let me clutch thee. I had thee not, and yet I see thee still. Art thou not fatal vision, sensible to feeling as to sight? Or art thou but a dagger of the mind? A false creation proceeding from the heat-oppressed brain. I see thee yet. In form as palpable as this which now I draw. Thou marshalst me the way that I was going. And such an instrument I was to use. Mine eyes are made the fools of the other senses. Or else with all the rest, I see thee still. And on thy blade and touching gouts of blood, which was not so before. There's no such thing. It is the bloody business which informs thus to mine eyes. Now, all the one half world nature seems dead. Wicked dreams abuse the curtain sleep. Witchcraft celebrates pale Hecate's offerings. And withered murder, alarmed by his sentinel, the wolf, whose howls is watched, thus, with his stealthy pace, with Tarquin's ravishing strides, towards his design moves like a ghost. Thou, sure and firm, said earth, hear not my steps. Which way they walk, for fear thy very stones prate of my whereabout, and take the present horror from the time that now suits with it. Whilst I threat, he lives. Words to the heat of deeds, too cold breath gives.
Attend, noble souls, to your health and vitality daily reminder. Today's thought: the eagle suffers little birds to sing, and is not careful what they mean thereby, knowing that with the shadow of his wings he can at pleasure stint their melody. Heed this thought and don't let slip your journey to wellness. Brought to you by the Wellness Reminder. Available now.
Open your ears, for which of you will stop the vent of hearing when loud rumors speak? I from the Orient to the drooping West, making the winds my post horse. Still, unfold the axe commenced on this ball of earth. Upon my tongues, continual slanders ride. The witch, in every language I pronounce, stuffing the ears of men with false reports. I speak of peace, while convert enmity. Under the smile of safety, wounds the world. And who? But rumor. Who? But only I make fearful musters and prepare defense. Whilst the big year, swollen with some other grief, is thought with child by the stern tyrant war, and no such matter. Rumor is a pipe blown by surmises, jealousies, conjectures, and so easy and so plain to stop that the blunt monster with uncounted heads, the still discordant, wavering multitude can play upon it. I won't need either my well-known body to anatomize among my household. Why is rumor here? The post come tiring on, and not a man of them brings other news. Then they have learnt of me. From rumor's tongues bring smooth comfort false. Worse than true wrongs.
The time is upon us. Which of these fallen citizens will ye elect to freedom? Voting lines are open now.
Hark and listen to the news just in. Our glorious leader hath named his worthy successor, ushering in a new chapter for our noble realm. Let us turn to our political reporter, Richard Bordeaux, live on site to share this epical tale.
In a triumphant fanfare, our esteemed leader of the realm hath named his son as successor, to rule alongside his daughter until she weds and retires to have the next generation of this hallowed family of rulers, shaping a new era of governance. More on this to follow. Back to you, Akira.
I prithee, join us anon at the ninth hour, as we delve deeper into this tale, following the little sleep.
Rejoice, dear citizenry. The time hath come to reveal the chosen voice from among your number. Behold, the winner of thy noble submissions, who speaketh of the wrong most great against them by another.
These two have ticed me hither to this place, a barren, detested vale, you see it is. The trees, though summer, yet forlorn and lean, o'ercome with moss and baleful mistletoe. Here never shines the sun. Here nothing breeds, unless the nightly owl or fatal raven. And when they showed me this abhorred pit, they told me, here, at dead time of the night, a thousand fiends, a thousand hissing snakes, 10,000 swelling toads, as many urchins,
would make such fearful and confused cries, as any mortal body hearing it should straight fall mad, or else die suddenly. No sooner had they told this hellish tale, but straight they told me they would bind me here unto the body of a dismal youth, and leave me to this miserable death. And then they called me foul adulteress, lascivious goth, and all the bitterest terms that ever you did hear to such effect. And had you not by wondrous fortune come this vengeance on me, had they executed. Revenge it!
And the prize is revealed. The accused villain's tenure begins in chains. The winner hath decreed it. Justice shall be served.
Behold, Sir Aneering, the Ring of Solace, a beacon of calm amidst life's tempests. This fair device worn upon thy hand doth weave tranquility and joy into thy spirit. Let it banish the cares that cloud thy mind as it cradles thee in comfort, its gentle touch a balm for thy weary soul. Embrace thy days with newfound ease, and let Sir Aneering be thy guide to a life of calm and bliss. Available now.
Your favor has been tallied and results verified. The victorious inmate with public favor for this round is...